Reading Srimad Bhagavatam 429-2b. Adhistam Dhistavam Nanchen Bhutam Swapanavar Anjata Bhutam Bhavad Bhavishyacha Suptam Sarvarahoraha. This Adhistam, future happiness, Dristavat, like direct experience, Nanchet, becomes vanquished, Bhutam, the material existence, Swapnavat, like a dream, Anyata, otherwise, Bhutam, which happened in the past, Bhavet, present, Bhavishyat, future, also, Suptam, a dream, Sarva, a world, Rahaha, Rahaha, the secret conclusion. Translation, everything happening within time, which consists of past, present and future, is merely a dream. That is the secret understanding in all Vedic literature. Please respond. Everything happening within time, which consists of past, present and future, is merely a dream. That is the secret understanding in all Vedic literature. Purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Factually, all of the material existence is only a dream. Thus, there is no question of past, present or future. Persons who are addicted to karmakanda vichara, which means working for fruitive future happiness through fruitive activities, are also dreaming. Similarly, past happiness and present happiness are merely dreams. The actual reality is Krishna and service to Krishna, which can save us from the clutches of Maya, for the Lord says in Bhagavad Gita 7.14, Mam eva e prapadyante mayam etantarantite. Those who surrender unto me can easily cross beyond my illusory energy. Thus then the purport of Bhaktivedanta, purpose of the 4th canto, 29th chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam, entitled Talk Between Narada and King Prachinabhahi. Vamajnanati mirandasya gyananam gyana shilaka chakshudan militam yenatasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya manobhistam satvitam yenabhutale Swayam Rupa Gadamam Dadati Swaparandikam Vandeham. Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurum Vaishnavam Cha Shri Rupam Sakajatam Sahagana Raghunatham Vitam Tam Sajim Shadvitam Shavadutam Parajanam Shahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakam Chamtham. Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopisha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchna Gorangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Shavanu Stuta Devi. Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. नमोम विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमती भक्ति वेदांत स्वामीति नामिनि पश्चात देश तारिणी गौरभक्तवृंदा हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। So today's subject is very interesting. Can see how the whole material world is compared here like a dream. Why this analogy is explained? Because when we wake up, we think this is real. When we go to sleep, we think that is real. But actually both is not real. Yes? Is the dream real? Is this real? Very real like. But it is also all these things, all are happening inside the dream world of the Lord. You understand? Let's see how powerful He is. He is lying down the yoga, he is in yoga nidra. Nidra means sleeping, you know, but his sleeping is not like us. He is sleeping and in his sleep, all this thing is going on. Can you imagine? And he incarnates also inside. Correct? We can read here, we can see his verses. Actually, the living entity is transcendental to material existence. But because of his mentality of lording it over material nature, his material existential condition does not cease. And just as in a dream, he is affected by all sorts of disadvantages. See? The living entity is actually transcendental. You follow? But because he is put into material existence, correct? Then the whole thing is like a compared to a dream-like situation. You see, explain here. You follow? So that means this whole thing, this illusory thing, is completely in a dream situation. You have to understand, you know. Therefore, we are here. Sometimes we are crying. We are becoming happy. The situation is very not real, temporary. Of course it's real, but it's temporary, it's not permanent. Just like a dream, it is not permanent. Correct? When you wake up, you don't care for your dream. Yes? Yes or no? When you're sleeping, you don't care for your so-called real life. Both ways you don't care. So which one you say is real? You see, that's why the next verse. So third canto, chapter 27, verse 4. Fourth canto, chapter 20. The same point is explained in all these places, you know. So let's go and see. One by one. Actually, the living entity is transcendental to material existence, but because of his mentality of lording over material nature, this material existence, existential condition does not cease. And just as in a dream, is affected by all sorts of things. The same verse, they repeated, you know, how many times? It's repeated in Sanskrit. Arteha avidyamanepi samsthitina nirvartate jayato visayam asya swapne na artagamo yata. This same verse repeated so many places in the Bhagavatam. We just read, no? 11, what is that? 3, 27, 4, 4, canto, chapter 29, verse 35 and 73. Two times is repeated in 35 and 73. See this verse here? We read this verse, no? Again, same thing, okay? But the last line is changed. Manasa linga rupena swapne vicharato yata. I think I gave a class on this two verses, right? Is it not? Sometimes we suffer because we see a tiger in a dream or a snake in a vision. But actually there is neither a tiger nor a snake. Thus we create some situation in a subtle form and suffer the consequence. These sufferings cannot be mitigated unless we are awakened from our dream. So in order to come out of this dreamlike situation, we must wake up. You follow? And this tiger and all this is created in a, by our mental concoction. Actually there is no tiger, but we see that real, the tiger is coming, chasing me, sometimes snakes here. Yeah? Correct? Have you witnessed that? No? Huh? Correct? Something terrible, you know? Next one is what? 73, yeah?
Going, huh?
35. Again here, same verse again. This one is exactly the same. When the living entity dreams, the sense objects are not actually present. However, because one has associated with the sense object, they become manifest. Similarly, the living entity with undeveloped senses does not cease to exist materially, even though it may not be in exactly in contact with the sense objects. You see how this whole science is so real, that when you dream, all these things are manifest in a very realistic form. You know, it is not just like you're watching a movie, you know. You see, when you watch a movie, it is all one dimension, correct? Is it not? You are seeing, you know, the movie is going, correct? But you cannot feel the movie. Can you feel? You cannot smell, you cannot taste. These things you cannot do. But in a dream, you are seeing, you are tasting, you are smelling, everything happens. Yes? Notice the difference. That means, in the subtle form, these all are created in a very realistic manner. Like, for example, the tiger chasing. There's no tiger. But you are seeing the tiger coming, running, charging, you know, it's going to kill you. And you start screaming, yes. But actually, it's a dreamlike situation. Isn't it? Yes. This is how the living entity is covered by Maya. Maya is so powerful. That's why it's subject to illusion. The moment the living entity takes birth in the material world, immediately Maya covers the conditioned soul. He identifies the body. See? Then here, again, exactly the same verse, eh? How many times this verse is repeated? Again, the translation is a little different. For one who is meditating on sense gratification, material life, although lacking factual existence, does not go away. Just as the unpleasant experience of a dream do not. See? You follow? So, the only way, I think we read this right in 429, those who remember? You remember 429, how to come out of dream-like situation? Narada Muni is telling, remember? You have to wake up, right? What is that verse?
429, 35,
we just read, no? That's the verse that he says you have to wake up from this thing. That only waking up is by the help of the spiritual master. Come on. 34. Narada continued, O you who are free from all sinful activity, no one can counteract the effect of fruitive activity simply by manufacturing a different activity devoid of Krishna consciousness. All such activities are due to our ignorance. When we have a troublesome dream, we cannot relieve it with troublesome hallucination. One can counteract a dream only by waking up. Similarly, our material existence is due to our ignorance and illusion. Unless we awaken to Krishna consciousness, we cannot be relieved of such dream. For the ultimate solution to all problems, we must awaken to Krishna consciousness. I remember this verse, right? Yes? So the solution to come out of the dream-like situation is to wake up. That's why our whole philosophy, they start with Jeev Jago, Jeev Jago. Is there any word that says you please sleep? Is there any word that say you please sleep? No, please sleep. Please, no, 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 you're tired, you sleep. Huh? Is there anything like that? Huh? A spiritual master is what? Wake up. What? Huh? Wake up. Jeev Jago is a song, right? You know the song? Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, Jeev Jago, Gaura Chandra Pole. Kota Nidra, Yava Maya, Pisache Kole. Yeah, how long you want to sleep in the lap of the witch called Maya? Correct? So the waking up is very important. Yes? The ultimate solution to all problems, we must awaken to Krishna consciousness. Without Krishna consciousness, you cannot come to this reality. If you engage in karma, jnana, all these kind of things, you cannot fully wake up. Yeah. You understand this point? See? Only in Krishna consciousness you can overcome my maya. Right? Proper quoted the verse 7:14, yes? Devi esha gunamayi mama maya turute mam eva prapadyante mayam etan karamiti. I think Prahlad Maharaj also said some verse on this waking up, right? Do you know? Do you know this verse? He said, Bharam Mutvato Vimudan. What? Seven, he to throw this burden down. What is that verse? 7:9? Yeah? 7:9. So here in this verse, Maya Sukaya Bharam Utvato Vimudan. O best of the great personalities, I am not at all afraid of material existence, for wherever I stay, I am fully absorbed in thoughts of your glories and activities. My concern is only for the fools and rascals who are making elaborate plans for material happiness and maintaining their family, society and country. I am simply concerned with love for them. Because they are making elaborate plans. You understand? They cover it by Maya. That Maya Sukha. See? You cannot see. For one who is enjoying his senses, Bhogeshwara Prasaktanam, Krishna said, correct? You know? Bhogeshwara Prasaktanam, you know, right? 2:44. For them, the resolute determination of devotional service cannot take place. If you want to enjoy Maya, there's no way you can see these things. Maya and Krishna is like oil and water. You cannot mix it. You cannot mix oil and you cannot mix. You understand? It is not possible. Yeah? Is it possible? Want to enjoy Maya and the same want to be Krishna conscious. Possible. Huh? That's not possible. Anyone who try to enjoy Maya, he will go so deep down that he will forget who he is. He will be completely what? Covered. He cannot figure it out. There are two verses are there. Actually I showed this verse many times. 4:22. 33 is it? For the soul, 30 I think. For the soul who is interested in Maya, he is so gone that the sadhu say his soul is lost. Huh? 4:22, 30. Because 5th canto also there, I mean 5:17 or 16 I always quote. See, for the soul, enjoying Maya is finished. Huh? It's completely covered by the dream-like situation. Yes? And once mind and senses are attracted to sense object for enjoyment, the mind becomes agitated as a result of constantly thinking of sense object. One's real consciousness almost becomes lost. Like water in a lake that is gradually sucked by the big grass straws on its banks. When one deviates When one deviates from his original consciousness, he loses the capacity to remember his previous position or recognize the present one. When remembrance is lost, all knowledge acquired is based on false foundation. When this occurs, learned scholars consider that the soul is lost. In other words, you can wake up only by Krishna consciousness, but if you don't, if you engage in Maya, then your consciousness is what? Vanish. And the killer of the soul goes where? What is the verse? Killer of soul. The one who is enjoying his senses is the killer of his soul. Come on.
10:14.
Come on. Hello.
10:14.
Hey. Ishopanishad. Mantra. Ishopanishad mantra what? Hare Krishna.
Mantra three.
Ishopanishad mantra. Killer of the soul, where he goes? What is it? In other places it says that he is the killer of the soul. But here, Asurya namate loka andena tamasa vrtaha tamste pretya abhiganchanti he ke cha atmo hano janaha. Atma hana
means
killer of the. Understand? Where he goes? Under. The killer of the soul, whoever he may be, must enter into the planet known as the world of faithless, full of darkness and ignorance. You understand this point? In other words, if you engage in sense gratification, live in this dreamlike situation, on and on and on, dreaming daytime, dreaming nighttime, that's all we are doing, correct? Daytime dreaming, nighttime dreaming. Daytime, what is the dreaming? How to get money, how to get women, how to get this, correct? Daytime dreaming. Nighttime, what is the dreaming? Correct? Yes. Both situation is correct. Yes, sir. So try to understand that. I think there is also one verse there in this 4:29 that you can only wake up in Krishna consciousness, and then I think it is 36 one that only by contact with the pure devotee, spiritual master. Is it 40 or what? 37? What is that number?
36.
See, you cannot wake up by your own strength. That's not possible. That is not possible. So if you sleep, this is what happens. But the only way you can come out, 37, see that? This is a very important point here. The real interest of the living entity is to get out of this nisaya that causes him to endure repeated birth and death. The only remedy is to surrender unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead through His representative. You cannot surrender the Supreme Personality of Godhead by your own self. That's not possible. Unless one renders, see that point here? Unless one renders devotional service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vasudev, one cannot possibly become completely detached from his material world, nor can he possibly manifest real knowledge. That means he cannot wake up. Unless you go to Krishna, you cannot wake up. That's not possible. My Maya is very powerful. You understand this point? So, the principle of spiritual master is very, of course, spiritual master means bona fide. We are not talking of any crazy spiritual master. That's useless. You can't wake up with that kind of spiritual. You know, spiritual master means what? Someone who gives you what? What does the spiritual master give? Nothing. What do you give? Samprasadam. What does spiritual master give?
To reach Krishna.
To reach Krishna.
How?
Yes. That's the point. He gives the what? The realization. Understand? The spiritual master gives that knowledge. And knowledge is very important. And this knowledge is not material knowledge. This is what?
Spiritual
knowledge. And only by spiritual knowledge the spirit soul can wake up and see the real thing. That's why in our school there's not just knowledge. The word knowledge is in English is one word only, knowledge. But in Sanskrit there are two words, there's what? And vijnanam. Not only just knowledge, theoretical knowledge anyone can have. But vijnanam, that is transcendental knowledge. Realization, vijnanam. Jnanam, vijnanam, astikyam. Brahman quality is not just jnana, that's also realization. And realized knowledge is very important. And realized knowledge will carry with you for the rest of your... You know, you never finish when you change body also. This knowledge will always be with you. Unless you go into Maya, then you get into all kind of nonsense, then temporarily it will be covered. And then again, by just like, what's his name? Bilba Mangal Thakur. He was actually a very pure devotee, but he fell down. You understand? Until again the prostitute woke him up, you know. What's the name? Chintamani. If only you had all this kind of attraction for Krishna, how big a devotee you would be, that woke him up, you know. So the knowledge was there. He had to be. That's why I say all of us are Krishna conscious. What is that verse? All of us are Krishna conscious, but we have to be again revived. Sarvanadi Sutta Chitte Krishna. What is that? 22, oh no. 20 I think. 20 or 22? What is that? Everything. 22. 10. So here you can see how we are all Krishna conscious. It's not that you are not Krishna Kani, you are all Krishna Kani, but need to be Nitya Siddha Krishna Prema Satya Khabu Naya Saranadi Sudachitte Karoya Udhaya. Pure love for Krishna is eternally established in the heart of the living entity. Eternally established in the heart of the living entity. It is not something to be gained from another source. When the heart is purified by hearing and chanting, this love naturally awakens. You understand this? And this is how it comes from the association of the spiritual master. The spiritual master enlightens the living entity with what? Knowledge. And then the realization comes. You follow? And it is so transcendental that this process, once you connect to Krishna, externally he brings the spiritual master. Internally Krishna also awakens the conditioned soul by giving him realization. Knowledge is something you have to get. It's not something you figure out. That's not possible of figuring it out. You know, this is such a thing. It's not that you can figure out. Forget it. You understand? Is there? Krishna says, yes. Krishna says here, you see what he does. You cannot figure out, there is no possible. You understand, this figuring business is only for the speculative. Let me offer my respectful obeisance unto the all-pervading Supreme Personality of Godhead who possess unlimited transcendental qualities, acting from within the cause of the heart of all philosophers who propagate various views. He cursed them to forget their own souls, while sometimes agreeing and sometimes disagreeing among themselves. Thus he creates within the material world a situation in which they are unable to come to a conclusion. I offer my respectful obeisance unto him. You understand this point? You cannot figure out. Krishna will delude you. You understand this? Are you following? You understand, the living entity, he is very, very, what we say, is in a very precarious position. He cannot do anything without the sanction of the law. Are you following? Hello? Anything expressed by material vibration, anything ascertained by material intelligence, anything experienced by material senses or concocted within the material mind is but an effect of the most material nature, and therefore has nothing to do with the real nature of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The Supreme Lord is beyond the creation of his material, for he is the source of the material qualities and creation. As the cause of all causes, it exists before the creation and after the creation. I wish to offer my respectful obeisance unto you. In other words, all this speculative material knowledge cannot what? With it you cannot understand God. It's not possible. Because it's all in the modes of material. So to go to the transcendental plane, only Krishna can help. That's why Krishna says, I am sitting in the heart, yes? And I am giving what? Knowledge? Forgetfulness? And remembrance. I am giving you. That means, can you understand, the soul is in a very, dream-like situation. You understand? Dreaming. This way is dreaming, that way also dreaming. Both ways is. And even if you go, if you talk about another dimension, we couldn't go into the spiritual world, we are also kept like that. But this way we are covered by yoga maya.
Krishna's maya will not let you go. Finish.
Either you want to be in Mahamaya or you want to be in... You understand? Don't think that you can be independent. That word is not... Every soul is tightly under the control of the... You understand? You can, you know the verse is, spirit soul is tightly under the control of the Lord. Do you know where it is? Huh? No? In this verse, Madhya 19 explain here how the spirit soul is totally under the wrap of Krishna. He cannot say he is independent, it is not possible. Yeah. What time is it? Finish, yeah? Oh, time finish. This is actually from the 10th 87, but translation here Prabhupada is giving. O Lord, although the living entities have accepted material bodies as spiritual and unlimited in number, if they were all pervading, there will be no question of they have been under your control. You understand? If they are what? All pervading, they cannot be under your... If they are accepted, however, as particles of the eternally existing spiritual entity, as part of you, Mamayangsa Jiva Loke, Jiva Bhuta Sanatana, who are the Supreme Spirit Whole, I mean you who are the Supreme Spirit Whole, we must conclude that they are always under your control. Understand? If they are all pervading, they are not under your control. But if you accept them as part and parcel of you, then you will conclude that the spirit soul is always under. It is not independent. Your free will is there. Either you want to accept which Maya? Either you want to accept my Mahamaya or you want to accept what? A choice. That choice is there. Krishna is kind enough to give the soul choice. Because love can only come with choice, no? You cannot force someone to love you. Is this possible? Cannot. It's not possible. Yes? If the living entities are simply satisfied with identical with you as a spirit particle, then they will be happy being controllers of so many things. Is that point again Krishna is making? If you come under my subjugation, then yes, I will let you control so many things. You want to be controller, right? You can only be controller if you work under my authority. You follow? This is Krishna. If you want to be controller, no problem. But you must work under my jurisdiction, right? Then you will be happy being controller of many things. The conclusion is that the living entity and the Supreme Personality of Godhead are one and the same is a faulty conclusion. It is not a fact. Yeah, the same in quality, we don't deny that. But in quantity, we are not the same. This is how this verse, Prabhupada, you know, is so relevant. It is actually 10.87.30. Yeah? But if you go there, the translation will be confusing. So, I like to show this translation of Prabhupada. You know, you follow. See how Prabhupada translates this, you know. If you want to be controller, no problem. But you must work under my control. Then yes, Krishna, you see all the Nitya Siddhas. Krishna, you know, gives them everything. Yes, same rupa, same opulence, same what? Same feature, correct? Same place, and also same opulence, all. And if you want, of course, my personal association, that's also there. But you see how Krishna gives everything, provided you accept my authority. But if you don't accept my authority, then forget it. Krishna will, what? Krishna say what? I will destroy you. Krishna say what? I'll finish you up. Forget it. You cannot survive. And that's what's happening, correct? You see, in this today's context, all the leaders are making big plans, you know, everyone thinking he's going to be the big controller, but they don't understand. Actually, Krishna is the Madhyakshana. What is that? 9, 10? What is that? Maya Adhyakshana. Prakriti. Characharanam. Everything is moving under my control. Don't think you mess around with Krishna. That's not possible. That's why Krishna says, for those who are mischievous, I cause them to lower and lower species where they stay there perpetually. Correct? Yes? So our position now, whether you want to come out of the dreamlike situation or you don't want to come out of the dreamlike situation. I have explained what is dream. Yes? Correct? Either this way or that way you become. That verse, you know? Yeah? 11, 28, 13. So that verse is so important. We went from there to so many verses explaining this dream-like position. Correct? And then the solution, Narada also said the solution. The solution is to become Krishna. Krishna consciousness means to have Guru, to get this knowledge. Getting this knowledge, we will then surrender. Then when we get our real, just like a crazy guy, you know, once he get cured, then he understands things as they are. Correct? So this is the sum and substance of the, that's why the conclusion of this, I think this verse was in between that 73 or somewhere. If you read Prabhupada said this verse is inserted,
yeah,
73 or something like that. So it's not just the last verse of that, of the chapter. The last verse is that Narada Muni is telling the Maharaj to go and quickly get out, you know, and he's inviting him also to come to his place, you know, that's the last. The real idea is that he has woken him up and you understand that he's so serious. Okay, I'm leaving now, correct? I also explained that point, not wasting time. I gave a class on that also, correct? Yes? So I think this verse is like a summary of that verse. So anybody got any questions or comments on this point that I have? Again, what is the word? Reiterated, is it? That word? I am not very accustomed to using very, very bombastic words. I like to use very simple words and drive the point. Prabhupada also, you know, use all kind of flamboyant words and then confuse everybody. That the Maya words like to do that. Yes.
Any questions? Any? He is expert on all this. He knows the vocabulary. His vocabulary is astonishing. I am not in that category. I am a layman. Only because you all are sitting here, these verses all came out. I didn't prepare this class. I don't know what I'm going to talk about. There's the potency of the devotees. Yes? I think I covered this subject in the previous verses. Yeah? I think this 29th chapter, our classes are very... we'll go back and refer to them. Yeah, 11. I remember the dream is 11, 28, 13, 14. Yeah, I think I did, but today I have not gone to the 14 and the 15. Because I already spoke, you know, I told you the... Because 11, the, sorry, the 4, 29, 34 is very important. That shows that how you can come out of Krishna's mind. Because there's also another verse, 11:11:48 also. Without devotee help, you cannot... not possible. That's why what Bhagavad Gita Krishna is speaking, Devi is a Gunamaya, it's very like simple. It is not that just simply Devi is a you are, you surrender to me, you can overcome. That surrender has to come with the help of the spiritual master. That Krishna, he puts it very simple. Oh, I just surrender. Because Bhagavad Gita, no, he has to speak in a simple way. But you really want to surrender, then you have to know how to surrender. Yes? You understand? That goes in a whole program. Taking shelter of the spiritual master. Right? That's why the verse there. What is that verse? Tasmat Jyagyasu Guru Prapadye. Yes. If you don't surrender to spiritual master. Surrender to spiritual master means, I have explained also, it is not that you become official in the surrender. Hare Krishna Prabhu, Hare Krishna, this doesn't work. I showed you the word. You have to surrender means you have to surrender. No, not that you hi, you know, this won't work. You understand? This hi business can go on for millions of years. Nothing will happen in your heart. Just like Arjuna, correct? I want to be your disciple. Sadhi Mam Prapana. You order me now what I should do. That thing must come. If you don't surrender, we can come here for 300 million years. Hello Prabhu, very nice Prabhu, you spoke nicely. Huh? You understand? It will not work. I think I quoted the verse right, you know, 11:3:29. 11:3:29 in that purport, Bhaktisiddhanta is writing. You cannot be an official devotee. You must be what? Take up the process, surrender, crying, please save me. Otherwise it's not going to work enough. Any other questions, comments? Busy cooking, huh? Wow, you have surrendered. Surrender to serve the devotees. All right, any other thing to add? Okay, we'll stop here then. Thank you very much. Grantharaj Mahabharam Ki.